Greetings, one and all, from Kit Kat and me. Hey, little chap. Busy wanting to lick your bum again. Bye. All right. So, hope everyone is well today. I am going to set about completing this artwork today. With a squiggle here and a squiggle there. So let's get about it then, shall we? Trying to get my ducks in a row. Basically adding a few sort of minor details today. And given that, as I said yesterday, my laptop screen seems to be packing in. In fact, I can't even get it to start up properly now. I'm basically working intuitively now to finish off, and which just goes to show once again that a reference image is purely that, just to get the basics. So, which I have, and now that the image is imprinted on my mind, I don't have to refer to it that much now. What am I going to be doing today? Ah, yes. So today really is about just working on the overall. Enhancing some colors here and there, some contrast perhaps. This play of light is what's important as well. So I'm just going to be very subtly working with that as well. Of course, what you see on your screen, on your on this video is colors a lot softer. They seem to be from my side. but up here it's, look, there's my resident mozzie again coming to irk the hell out of me. Yeah, there's a lot more definition apparent as I work on this piece. And I'll try to capture that in the final image that I usually post up. And it's, although even that is very difficult to capture the subtleties. Anyway, we do our best. And aside from some of my acrylic work that I'll be doing later on, you'll barely see any difference in the work that I'm doing. I'm just literally going around, tying off loose ends, little details that I might see, observe. Isn't that right, Kiket? Eh? Kit, you're in my way. You're in my way. Yeah. I'm really enjoying the the way this concrete has developed a character all of its own, almost. The role player, one of the major role players in this piece, and it's really spoken out more than I had expected it to. Who would have thought that concrete would have been a major role player? So over you, damn mosquitoes, and they just get away. Right, I'm going to do a little bit of work down this end, simply because I don't want it to be neglected. And also I want to enhance the contrast a little bit. Just with this kind of grayish brown, got a gray tint to it. There's one set of pastels here that have a slightly different tonal value to the others. Similar hue, range of hues, but and colors, but just with a tint. And quite interesting. Of course, I haven't got these massive sets of pastels to work with. They're just exorbitantly expensive these days. So. Much as I would like to, they are. I make do with what I have. A couple of small sets plus the odd loose pieces that I buy, especially the some of the pale blues, the lilacs and the white, of course, is what I need the most of, what I use the most of. So I usually would get those. The sets last quite a lot longer. The individual pieces. Some of them go untouched, of course, especially when I'm working with my seascapes. Anyway, so I'm just pulling a little bit more of the character of the concrete up here. The roughness of it, the weatheredness of it. And literally just doodling, squiggling around. I'm going to do the same with my charcoal. So ever so stubborn, these damn charcoal sticks sometimes get out. They get a knot in them and then you can't. They won't budge. Brittle and there we go, I've got rid of the knot. It's either that or they kind of sometimes get a little bit overbaked in the making of them, because that's really all it is. That's all charcoal sticks are. They obviously dry the wood out, the twigs out first, and then fire them, bake them for a very specific amount of time, but. Sometimes I think some of them get a little bit overdone and they become flinty and brittle. Will do. Right. Contact crayon white, just trailing around. just bringing up some highlights here and there. I wonder if I should attempt with this a little bit with my white pastel. Obviously being much softer than the Conte, it does take a lot easier and a lot more to the surface. It's not quite what I'm looking for though. I'm going to bring a bit of blue here now. Wait a second. Just wanted to pull this golden yellow that the bottom of the steps are reflecting the sunlight as they fade away there. I just wanted to enhance that a little bit so you can get the that subtle transition. Because then the bottom of the pool itself is down and beyond that. There's definitely this little bit of concentration required, so not talking much. Just very, very soft pressure with my black Conte, just scratching a few little squiggles out here. Now with my blue, pale blue, now I've been over it before, and then I, as you would have noticed, I have blended a lot of the colors together with my eraser, and now I'm going over it again, so the colors then punch out, but more as line. So what I'm working on here is the pale reflection of off the water surface, just as it catches the light, and as it fades into the distance, so it reflects the light even more because of its angle, well, predominant angle of the general surface of the water. Here it's more looking down on it, there it's more looking at a more acute angle at it. Once again, this is an artwork of subtleties. There's no great contrast either in color or in light and shade. I think it's time for a wee bit of lilac as well, here and there. Not that one. Which one shall I use here? This one. Again, I'm being very gentle with this. just a very subtle fleck here and there to catch the eye. Clamp off now. For some reason, I don't know why, but for some reason, within the same range of brand of pastels, the consistency of their pastels changes. Some are harder than others, and I don't like that. Gosh, I wish they would get it right. And the other thing that is my absolute bugbear with these pastels is the inconsistency with their wrappers. The paper wrappers have got this glue on them that doesn't like to come off. You can't take the wrapper off without leaving this residual of glue, and it's awful damn stuff. You have to scrape it off with your fingernail. Whereas others, such as my pale blue and white, have got a plastic wrapper which comes off much easier and doesn't leave a residual. Why? I don't know. Maybe old stock that they're getting rid of? I don't know. I must actually query that. I keep forgetting to every time I go. So you take a couple of examples to show them, because their supplier must actually rectify this. It's not good, very poor. And this is their a range that they carry in loose pastels. And it's quite an extensive range, but the wrappers are different on all of them. And I've got a feeling that these paper wrappers are the old stock, and the plastic ones are the newer stock. I'm just assuming, but they're not nice at all. Mind you, I've been moaning about this for ages now. So I don't know, it might not be that. Can't think of any other reason why though. Yes, okay. So for next week's series, I am going to have to consider something perhaps more intuitive. Maybe it's my lucky break to get a little bit more abstract with things. I don't know, we'll see. Noses will be out of joint, but you should know by now that I'm not overly into creating pretty pictures. I prefer to stretch it somewhat. And given that my access to reference imagery excuse me, is limited now, maybe I should apply myself to something completely different. Let's see. Yeah, it's coming together satisfactorily. Yes, this is definitely a piece of an artwork of exploring texture and the balance of color in applying technique to create that given textures to describe the character of this cement versus that of the water, and how they work together cohesively in an image visually, and how perhaps they can, in their togetherness, stimulate the senses. I can only speak for myself. in terms of being the one interpreting, tasked with interpreting this, but it seems to be working. I get that feel of that almost powdery but rough surface of the concrete here, with these little stone chips, some of them sharpish, because they're granite chips, and whereas the concrete itself is much more able to be eroded and smoothed. Yet it's worn away over time, exposing these little stone chips. So you get that kind of feeling, and then you get this very serene, soft almost appearance of the water, coolness with the greens and what have you. So yes, it's been an interesting piece. Most definitely. Once again, just softening it, softening off the pastel and conte work with my eraser. Smoothing, smudging, blending. And just adding yet another subtle texture here and there. Right, I'm going to now use a little bit of acrylic paint. Now, should I use my palette knife for this, or should I use my brush? Let's take the plunge. I think it's a brush that is needed, but a very fine brush. Let's see how this goes. It's only here that it really needs to sparkle, because this rail, balustrade, whatever, is stainless steel, and the only aspect of this piece which is silvery reflective, that reflects the sunlight most brightly, but even so, it's only on this one edge. It's just on that edge of the handrail that catches the light, and I want to pull up. Just on that curve for the most part. Right, that'll do. I don't want to overdo it, you see. I don't want to have any, because of the minimalistic approach to this artwork, I don't want to have any aspect of it that that stands out too overly boldly from anywhere else. So I think I've done as much as I need to in terms of that now. I need to take off the square edges there. That's for sure. Okay, I can breathe again. I am absolutely useless in catching mosquitoes. Absolutely useless. I think that they can read my mind, to be honest. To finish off with a little subtle touches of darker greens on the sort of mossy area. Again, very subtle. Right, I'm done. Just like that. Just like that. Let's sign off. Yep, 20 22. There we go. There we go, folks. So yeah, this one draws to a close, and I'm quite happy with the result. So thank you for joining me this past few days. And thank you for bearing with me through all my meanderings. Do tune in again next week, because I shall be doing something. I don't know what yet, but remains to be seen. If you are only watching on YouTube and you would like to connect with me on Facebook, on Instagram, please do so, because I also share some stills, images of this piece and a little description and what have you about it as well. Feel free to do so. Send me an invite or a friend request or whatever. The high definition quality of this video is brought to you by ks3.com. So very grateful for that, for our fiber. And so do have a good, wonderful weekend, and catch you again next week. Do take it easy, take care, oodles of toodles, and be good, be kind, be caring, and see you soon. Bye. Don't forget to doodle.